ever became of. I'm living on the air in Cincinnati. Cincinnati, WKRP. Got kind of tired of packing and unpacking. Town to town, up and down the dial. Maybe you and me were never meant to be. Just maybe think of me once in a while. I'm at WKRP in Cincinnati.
This is what the final dish will look like. Delicious, isn't it?
The ingredients I will use for this Cincinnati Bison Chili are 1 pound of ground bison, some garlic, 1 can of diced tomatoes, banana peppers, green bell peppers. For some heat, we add 2 jalapeno peppers, onion, a can of red kidney beans, and a can of chili beans, which are pinto beans, so pinto beans and kidney beans. Spices I will use are basic chili powder and brown black pepper. Hi, gonna make some chili. It's cold outside, warm inside. Cold outside. Ooh, the weather outside is frightful, but my chili's gonna be so delightful. So if there's no chili to eat, you're screwed, you're screwed, you're screwed. Hot chili and crock pot inside. So here we go. This is how you make it. Watch. Peppers and onions. Throw it in. I say, what's the sense in having a crock pot if you can't just throw stuff in and then walk away from it and go on with your life? So these are the peppers and the onions. No garlic in here yet. Okay. 1 can diced tomatoes in there. Kidney beans, along with all the juices thrown in there. Pinto beans, along with all the chili juices thrown in there. Okay, I'm now adding the pound of bison meat and garlic. Hey, I got a guest. Patsy Cat's helping me cook. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to let this cook down a little bit. I'm going to cover this. I like cooking easy, especially with the crock pot. Cover it like that, and I'll come back in 1 hour, and we'll see how it looks. 1 hour later, here is the bison chili. See the meat? I kind of threw it on top, and I didn't bother to cook it. No need to cook it because it's going to cook all day long. It's only been in here for 1 hour. It still has, I'd say, at least another 5 or 4.5 hours to go. And there's certainly no way that this bison or beef isn't going to cook in that amount of time in a decent crock pot. So getting it mixed up, looks nice and thick and hearty. Here comes some chili powder on. I put lots on because I love things spicy. And fresh ground pepper. And I'll give this a good stir. Look at that. I think it looks pretty good. Okay, here we go. I'm going to cover it and leave it on high for another 4 hours. Here we are, 2 hours later after covering it. I want to give it a stir. You can see how this bison went in raw. Look how nicely cooked it is now. No problem. Man, does this look good? I love every second of it. This will continue to cook for 2 more hours. And we'll then be ready. Here it is. The chili. After 4 hours of cooking, this is how it now looks. Doesn't that look so warm and delicious? And see the steam rising off of it? So after 4 hours, this is what we now have. It's a thick consistency. Has some juices to it. See that? I'm going to take this and put this over spaghetti. I'm now boiling 1 pound of spaghetti, and that's what makes it Cincinnati. I don't know how particular you need to be to call it Cincinnati chili, but you just add the spaghetti to me, and it's Cincinnati. I have a bowl, as you can see, of some chili. Spaghetti. I'm going to add chili right on top of this. There it is. Warm Cincinnati bison chili.